Welcome to another video by the trader guy, Chris, at thetraderguy.com. In this quote-unquote chart of the day video, it's actually going to be two charts. I have in front of you a light sweet crude forecast, futures chart that shows what happened on September 19th, which is when I'm recording this, during the trading day. Now, a little background, essentially there was talk about the Saudis releasing more oil. There's been rumors of an SPR release. There's also was a report that came out during the session that suggested that the United States had more oil in stock than originally anticipated after Hurricane Isaac, etc., etc. So because of this, we had a lot of bearish action in the oil market. And you can see we kind of broke down a little bit, depending on where you would draw a trend line. I suppose you could draw one there. The thing about oil, though, is I had nothing to do with shorting it. I didn't even look at the trade. And the reason being is, yes, we broke the 95 level. That was significant. But we also have the 90 now. We're already more than halfway there. There's some support here at about 88, 85, and on and on. You can see it's a nice stair-stepping market where that's all it's been doing. It's been stair-stepping up, and this is the most difficult market to sell when it's like this. Now, the reason I bring this up isn't for the oil, but as we all know, the Canadian dollar is greatly influenced by oil prices. So, when you see a chart like this, 9 times out of 10, you will see the Canadian dollar lose value. And this brings me to the dollar CAD chart. I found this interesting that the correlation completely broke down. Now, I'll zoom out real quick on the weekly chart, and you can see what the lines are all about. I essentially called it as a little bit of a consolidative area over the last, say, almost 2 years, and this rectangle got broken down recently. Of course, that's very bearish. That, you know, you measure the rectangle and it gives you a move down to 0.92 before it's all said and done. Very, very bearish action in the dollar against the Canadian dollar. And of course, this makes sense because oil prices were rising. The Federal Reserve is working against the value of the dollar. It's doing more quantitative easing, and that always affects the currency. So, zooming back in on the daily chart, and I'll zoom it up a little bit in case you don't have the ability to see it. You can see the last couple sessions have been interesting. We had a hammer, and then we've had a gradual rise. Well, this 98 handle is the bottom of previous support, as I just showed you. So this level suddenly becomes very interesting. But what caught my attention, and sometimes markets will give you a little bit of a heads up ahead of time, is the fact that look at what happened in the Canadian dollar the same day that oil plunged. Here we are. It's looks like we're going to close the day here in about an hour. It's that kind of strange time of day where basically the Australians are the only people, or the Kiwis and the Australians are the only ones trading. So I don't expect a whole lot of movement, but look at how this day is going to end. Slightly negative. In other words, the Canadian dollar gained barely gained, but more importantly, it didn't lose when oil fell apart. So what does this tell us? The easiest thing to infer from this is the correlation did not hold. That means that while oil is falling apart and a Canadian dollar isn't moving, that means perhaps the Canadian dollar is much stronger than we anticipated. Certainly surprised by this move. When I saw it, and I wasn't sitting in front of the computer today, but when I saw the charts when I came home, I thought, oh, the Canadian dollar is probably back up in this range, because I had been looking at this, figuring that if we could get above this area, it might rise back to 1.04. So the fact that I saw oil doing that, I thought, well, maybe we got up there. Maybe, I expect to see a large green candle. Well, I saw this. This tells me that, number one, oil's probably going to be difficult to short. And, I showed you that on the other chart. And the Canadian dollar is much stronger than we anticipate. And it looks like the 0.98 level really will more than likely hold as resistance. Now, there's no way to guarantee this, but this is kind of a tell. You know, these two tend to move in tandem. And because of that, it has to catch your attention. Looking at another petrocurrency, the Norwegian krona, you can see that the dollar krona fell slightly during the session as well. The Noki, which is what a lot of traders will call the NOK, is highly, highly influenced by oil prices. And yet, we have another instance where This barely moved. It did almost the exact same thing as the Canadian dollar. So now that we've seen strength in Canadian dollar, or lack of weakness is probably a better way to put it, and lack of weakness in the Noki, now we can say that both the Noki and the CAD are strong. Or conversely, is the dollar really that weak? So seeing this, you can see that the correlations did not hold because these two are inverse because the dollar is front, so they tend to go down when oil goes up. And it makes sense. Canada exports a lot of oil to the United States, and the Norwegians export a lot of oil. A lot of people don't know that, but they have a lot of rigs in the North Sea drilling for oil. So this petrocurrency did the same thing that the other petrocurrency did. So either the market doesn't believe in the oil move, and quite frankly, I think that's short-lived anyways, or the dollar's that weak, or the Canadian dollar and the Nogi are that strong. Now, I don't want to get too far out into the woods and say, well, I need to delve into the Norwegian economy or the Canadian economy. But what I do see on these two charts is that these petrocurrencies are not selling off. So petrocurrencies still look like a viable play. If you're afraid of that because of what's going on in the oil markets, you can take a look at the US dollar. Looks like the US dollar is going to weaken. So the point of this video was you can take one market, look at another, and kind of come up with a thesis. And so far, my thesis is weak US dollar. That's the only commonality, because the US dollar should be doing better against the petrocurrency when oil markets fall. Now, at this point in time, you can branch out and say, is the CAD and the NOK, are they strong against other currencies? And you can really drill down and get, more complicated than you need to on this. But this, to me, says more than likely, and I would prefer, truthfully, the dollar CAD because it's a little bit more cleaner and it's a little more laid out because of the previous consolidation that I showed you here. That I think we are probably going to see lower prices. We've had a little bit of a pop this week, but that's pretty limp considering what happened in oil. And then, of course, the daily again, that's really not much. So, looking at that, you can see that sometimes correlations break down and they tell you something. And this screams dollar weakness. If you have any questions, feel free to email me at chris@thetraderguy.com. Of course, you can sign up for the free forum. Plenty of hours of videos, all free, and covers all aspects of trading that you need essentially to become successful. Thanks a lot.